Good afternoon. Welcome to this webinar titled How Will You Benefit from BIM? Today I'm here with my colleague Maarten Sonneveld. My name is Jaap Groen. We both work for Map Content.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Maarten. Yeah, and the topic for today is How Will You Benefit from BIM? And this webinar is aimed at manufacturers. And today we'd like to discuss first briefly what is BIM and how and what exactly is the role of manufacturers in BIM. And further on this webinar, we'd like to to tell you more on how you can use BIM to publish your products, so engineers can use these in their BIM projects. And at the end, so BIM engineers will actually use your products and purchase them for use in projects. First of all, if you have any questions, the GoToWebinar panel, this is where you can type in your questions. So feel free to ask any of your questions. We have another colleague of ours here, Stefan, who's happy to join to answer any of your questions. So yeah, I would invite you to type in your questions here. We try to answer these right away. If not, after this webinar, we have a quick Q&A session where we can go further into your questions. First of all, map content. What is map content? We describe ourselves as the BIM platform for MEP engineers. As you know, there are quite some BIM platforms nowadays, but we'd like to focus on the MEP industry. And this is, on our platform, we offer uniform Revit models and also AutoCAD files. By now, we have a community of over 28,000 MEP engineers, and we're proud to host content from more than 270 plus manufacturers in the MEP domain. And we're happy to, we can offer you more than MEP engineers more than 500,000 articles. And with these articles, we have a global reach, so which means we have articles which can be used in BIM projects all over the world. Of course, there are a lot of demands nowadays in terms of quality. And we think it's really important that MEP engineers really work with content which is can be used all over the BIM cycle. And this is why we have our EMCS content standard. And this content standard describes exactly what content should look like and what data it should have, what parameters, and what type of detail, for example, to make sure it matches BIM standards all over the world, and but to also make sure that it can be used in all different projects. Now, about our platform numbers, this quickly gives you an overview of the size of our platform in terms of users and also in terms of downloads. And as you can see, BIM is really taking over the world, looking at our increasing number of engineers on our platform. Map Content is part of Stabiplan. Stabiplan is a Dutch company. We're located in Bodegraven in the Netherlands. Already here for more than 27 years. And we've always had a focus on the MEP industry here in the Netherlands and now also worldwide. We build software based on the Revit and AutoCAD platform. And what we try to do is combine software and data from most of the MEP manufacturers. And how we do this is what we will focus on later. I have about 170 employees and colleagues. And more than 10,000 people are using our software. And we have offices, sales offices, and both development offices in 5 countries in Europe. Now, what exactly is BIM? BIM has been around for quite some time, so I'm just assuming here most of you will know what BIM is. But just to give you a brief idea of what it is, this is called the BIM cycle, and what you see here. And BIM is all about the eye, information, also data. Data is all around the BIM cycle, and because all stakeholders combine data, we can be sure that the projects will be better. And just to give you a few examples of where data is used in the BIM cycle, already in the detailed design, this is where products are already placed, and also map content products. So for example, when making a detailed design, air conditioners, piping, electrical products will be placed. And it's important that these already have all the detailed data. Also analysis. This is where system analysis are being made by engineers. So in order to make good analysis, the data used in the system should be good. Looking at the documentation part of the cycle speaks for itself. This is where we talk about technical parameters, but also manuals. This should be good. Operation and maintenance, almost at the end of the BIM cycle. Of course, building operation managers need to have good data in order to maintain the building and to keep it in a good shape. Now, what exactly is the manufacturer's place in BIM? Some people think BIM is only for people who are actually working in design. Well, what we say is that all stakeholders in the construction industry have a place in BIM, and maybe manufacturers have the most important role in the BIM cycles. They are the owners of the source data. They have to provide the key data in order for BIM engineers to create good projects equipped with good product data. And at the end, manufacturers should provide good data so your customers can select your products and will actually use good products, which will work in the realization phase. Maarten, this is where I hand over the word to you.
Okay, Jaap, thank you very much. If there are any questions so far, of course, you can ask them in the question box from the GoToWebinar. I will now continue with how map content works together in the BIM cycle. As you can see here, we have a slide, map content and the BIM cycle. In close cooperation with leading manufacturers, map content offers free BIM files to map engineers worldwide. We have several services who are helping manufacturers to deliver right data, get them at the right place, and make engineers aware of the availability of your products. Here you see an overview of some of our services. And at the beginning, it starts, of course, with the creation. We'll go a little bit deeper in the next slides, but these are the six services: creation, publishing, marketing, the localization of content, integration, and analytics. So first of all, the creation of content. Of course, every manufacturer has its data available from the products. You have step files, SOT files, technical data sheets, name it. But the most important thing for engineers is that they can work with your data in projects. And when they are working in projects, they are often using software tools like AutoCAD or Revit or other software vendors. And for you, it's important to provide these engineers with the right information they can use in these programs. So what manufacturers need to do is provide AutoCAD DWG files, Revit families, and IFC files. And we are helping with them. So we are able to create this content for you. You can provide us your content or your data. And we have a content team who is able to build this specific files for you. After this is created, it's of course the case that we also publish the files. Well, as Jaap told, we are a platform. We are providing manufacturer data to engineers in AutoCAD and Revit files. So at our platform, you can find more than 28,000 engineers looking for mechanical, electrical, and plumbing components. One of the products you see here, it's a Viant product, I believe. And engineers can go to our platform and they can download this product for free directly into their model. They can select the different types. They can go to manufacturer deep links where they can retrieve more information about the product, about the maintenance, and so on. And it's also the GTIN number is also provided already. On the right side, you see the users per country. And what you can see here is that there are a lot of different countries around the world visiting the platform. It is very, as you all know, BIM is quite new to some countries. And that means some countries are ahead in this development, and some of them are still a bit behind. That's something we also see at our platform, that in the UK, for example, more and more engineers are working in BIM projects. Well, it's in Germany, for example, still mostly based on AutoCAD. So we also see this in the downloads of our Revit files. So we publish your components at our platform. We make them globally available for engineers, and they can go to the website, they can download them for free. And it's also possible to use applications to use to download files and products. Here you see an overview of some of our applications. They are especially designed and developed for Revit. And what these applications do is they help you, or they help engineers with the design of technical installations in a BIM environment. When you see the left top, you see a Map Content product line placer. That is a generic version or a generic app where several manufacturers are available to engineers. Engineers can download a trial version of this app, and they can start drawing different piping systems all within one application. Also, a very important role are the branded apps. As you see from Sana in this case, Map Content is also working closely with manufacturers to provide manufacturer-specific delivery programs or product programs. So what we have done for Sana is we created an application which contains all data and all product information from the Sana piping system, and we made it available in one Revit application. An engineer can therefore download this app, and he directly can start designing the complete Sana product range. We are also working on other apps like the ABB app. That's a possibility to configure switch ranges and place these electrical components in your Revit model. And of course, we are also working on different other applications. Yeah, it's also based on the request of manufacturers. So if you have any interested in if it's possible to provide your products in an application like this, please feel free to ask us about it, and we can see what we can do. Okay, I will give Jaap the mic.
Yes, thank you, Maarten. Thanks for that explanation. And of course, publishing is one, but then, well, only having content or an app on our platform is the basis. But of course, you also like to reach all of the MEP engineers, your own customers, probably potential customers on the platform or other platforms. And this is why we offer our marketing service. Our marketing services are not only, for example, your profile page on Map Content, which gives all contact information and information about your company. For example, here we see the company page for Italian manufacturer Calefi. Not only displaying all of the products, but also a YouTube video and direct contact details. Well, this is only one of the ways we'd like to give extra attention to manufacturers. Another way is our email database. Email, as you know, is a very important way of communication nowadays. We get a lot of emails, but what we also see is that email still is the number one way to reach people, and this is why we're, well, using email a lot to inform our users about new content, new manufacturers, also our apps and the way they work. And we have quite a large database. Besides all of our users, we also have Stabicat customers which like to receive our emails. All in all, we have more than 30,000 users in our email database across 60 countries. What we see is that open rates are quite good. So people are really happy to receive updates related to BIM content. Email really gives a push to your content downloads.
Okay, yeah, that looks really good. Does a manufacturer pay extra for this service? How does that work? Because it's like a marketing campaign?
It is a marketing campaign. It's a good question, but yeah, as I said, we really do think it's important that content on our platform is also promoted to our users. So the email tools we use is an extra service from manufacturers, which is not which comes at no extra cost. It's just we also like to see that people come to our platform and do download content. So this is completely free.
All right.
Besides that, we also think video is a really powerful channel. People like to see how content works in their Revit or AutoCAD project. And we do think this, it's easier to tell people this using video than tell them in text or an email. So this is why we create videos for new manufacturers for our apps, and also to show how to work with content in your BIM project. And we also offer this as a service to manufacturers. They can use the video on our on-map content, but also on their own website or perhaps on exhibitions. As an extra tool to inform customers on your BIM content. And last but not least, we also use our news section on our website to integrate it into an AutoCAD and Revit environment. The news channel for map content is integrated into Stabicad, the tool a lot of MEP engineers across Europe work with. And we also inform engineers on new content in this news channel. So yeah, that's what's regarding marketing. Martin, can you tell us a bit more about localization?
Of course, Jaap, I can. Thank you. Okay, about localization. Well, very often we are in close contact with manufacturers who are delivering different products in different countries all around the world. What you can see here, it's another example, also from Vaillant, I see. If you look down a little, you see several flags of countries. And before that, it says also available in. That means when an engineer is coming from one of these countries, he will find local information about this brand. So in case of a Spanish engineer, he will find, for example, Spanish deep links to manufacturer website. He will find the Spanish article numbers, or at least the local information he needs in his projects. And yeah, language is of course one of them, but it can also happen that they work with different article numbers or anything. Yeah, GTIN is of course always the same, but you can localize the data. So that's a very relevant thing. And what is also very interesting for this localization is that engineers only find the content which is actually available in the country. So they can, when it's available on map content, that means they can also buy these products in their country. So it does not make any sense when a Dutch engineer, for example, plays a product which is not even available in the Netherlands. So via this way, we make sure the content is always available in the country, and the engineer can actually buy the products. Okay, one of our services is also integration. Integration is a service where we connect with a manufacturer website. That means we establish a connection or a link to the manufacturer website, and via this way you can also present your BIM files at your website. The biggest advantage is to, when we create a link like this, you keep one source. Of course, it's very interesting for you as a manufacturer to reach your potential target group at map content, but it's also very interesting to serve your current customers via your own website. With this one source, it's very easy for us to maintain the content. So that means we can do updates when something is changing. We can edit things, name it, or everything is handled in one source. So you only have to look over one thing and make sure everything is right at this place. And also interesting to keep everything at one place is the analytics. So because you keep everything at one place, you get very valuable statistics and analytics. This will give you insight in how your users, potential customers, are behaving in the Revit and BIM environment. So you will see, for example, where the downloads are coming from, what products are my potential customers downloading, and yeah, what, how many times are my my products downloaded? So that also helps marketing or sales departments, yeah, in their business strategy. Of course, we also provide the application, which we discussed before. Well, here you see an example of a dashboard, how the statistics will look like for a manufacturer. Of course, we have blurred some things out because we have to deal with some privacy regulations. And but what we do, we provide manufacturers with a very detailed dashboard with download statistics. So in this overview, you can see where the downloads are coming from, which exact GTIN numbers are downloaded, and yeah, we are busy with expanding this download statistics more and more. Also, an overview of the map content downloads. Well, as you see, we have global reach, as Jaap mentioned before. Yeah, simply the engineers are coming from countries all over the world, and yeah, unless you localize your content and only make it available for Europeans, for Europeans, for example. And it's also about the app analytics indeed. So we can see the apps we are providing right now, they are used globally. So that's very interesting to see.
Yeah, it is indeed, Martin. Well, we already mentioned that we have about 270 manufacturers, and we're really proud to work together with these manufacturers. We try to offer MEP engineers a really broad range of different products. So as you can see here, quite some brands which are either active in electrical, mechanical, HVAC, plumbing segments. We try to add more products from different manufacturers to our platform every day. This is why we're really happy to discuss with manufacturers how we can help them to publish their content. And coming almost at the end of the of this manufacturer, we'd like to really to invite you to contact us if we interested you in any way, so we can further discuss your needs in terms of BIM, and we're happy to help where possible. Just to sum things up, how can you as a manufacturer benefit from BIM? Well, of course, when you upload BIM content to our platform, to your own website, to other different platforms, you are present with your products in front of engineers at a place where engineers are actively searching for products to use in their BIM project. This is one really important reason. Also, once you're placed in a BIM project, chances are really high this product will actually be purchased. So your product will actually end up in the actual building product. As Martin just demonstrated, we can provide you with really good insights in terms of usage of your products, BIM adoption across countries, different product ranges, and how they are used in different countries. It also acts as a extra marketing tool to give you to provide you with insights. And besides that, the world is changing fast. BIM is really helping to digitalize things. We see that data. We all know the terms such as big data. Data will only be more and more important these days. And I think it's really important for you as a manufacturer to go with the flow and be there where your customers are. So be at the forefront of manufacturer digitalization. And well, again, this is also what we'd like to ask you. We're more than happy to welcome you on our platform, and would like to invite you to join our community of manufacturers, so you can you can reach new markets. MEP engineers can find you. So again, feel free to contact us.
All right, thank you, Jaap. Well, we hope this webinar gave you a better insight in BIM, and also gave you some general information about map content and how map content is cooperating with many worldwide manufacturers. Of course, we have some more webinars available. These webinars will zoom in into specific topics, as you can see here on the left. Next time, on September 7th, we will handle a topic especially about content. Next time after that, it will be about apps. Also, we zoom into one application. We handle functionalities, trends, and also have a webinar about the switch range. So please feel free to subscribe to these webinars as well. Send us an email if you have any questions, and we stay a few more minutes online for questions. So feel free to ask them, and if we can't answer them directly, we come back to you after that. For now, I would like to thank you for your attention. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, as mentioned before, please feel free to contact us. Thank you.